Hello, America. My name is Kim Estes, and I'm here today with America's best-selling author of books on nutrition, Mr. Bob Barefoot. Bob is here today to give away to you a lifetime of free vitamin D. That's right, free vitamin D for a lifetime, for only a small shipping and handling charge. Why? Well, Bob Barefoot is here to tell you why. Bob, welcome to Hollywood.
Kim, I'm very glad to be here with you today.
Bob, almost every day on television, radio, and in the newspapers, there are stories on vitamin D and how it cures diseases such as cancer. Now, as I understand it, you have been researching vitamin D for over 35 years. And you've even written a book on it called Bob Barefoot on Vitamin D. I guess that makes you an expert on the subject.
It's true that for 35 years, I watched as Dr. Carl Riesch, medical doctor, used vitamin D to cure his patients. So being a scientist, I dove into researching the subject, and I soon found many other medical researchers were confirming Dr. Riesch's findings that vitamin D can indeed cure disease. In my books, I quote hundreds of these researchers. The answer is easy and understandable. It's because of what you just said. The key word was inexpensive. The Canadian Cancer Society has just put out a report that 15,000 IU of vitamin D, that's 50 cents worth, can eliminate over 65% of women's breast cancer. That means we can cure breast cancer for just 50 cents, and the drug industry wants to charge you $50,000 for a drug that probably does not work. They can't allow this to happen, so they've created a campaign to eliminate vitamin D from the market.
Bob, can you give me an example of what the drug industry is doing?
Kim, there are hundreds and hundreds of examples. The drug industry spends billions and billions of dollars in drug industry ads on television, radio, and in the newspapers. To kill a story, they only have to threaten to withdraw the drug ads. A good example of this happened on CNN in late 2006 when the lead story of the day was, quote, "A massive scientific study had just proved that vitamin D can eliminate over 50% of all cancers." Now, if there had been a drug that could do the same, it would be worth trillions of dollars and it would be advertised on every hour on television, radio, and in the newspapers. But since it was just God's inexpensive vitamin D, the hottest story of the decade disappeared the next day and CNN resumed receiving hundreds of millions of dollars from the drug industry.
Well, can you give us an example of something a little more recent?
Yes, just today. The LA Times had an article on vitamin D where it said that the elderly should take at least twice as much vitamin D as they're told to take. They want them to take 1,000 IU a day. And they said those who are obese should take at least 2,000 a day. And Dr. Sanjay Gupta, just a few months ago, did a lead story on vitamin D where he said that blacks who live far away from the equator, where there's less sun, have more than 20 times the heart disease. He also said that just 20 minutes in the sun can produce 20,000 IU of vitamin D. Well, this might be true for white Americans who produce 165 IU of vitamin D per square centimeter of skin. And with 20 square feet of skin, that adds up to 3 million IU of vitamin D per day is produced, which is equivalent to 40,000 IU over that 20-minute period. Black America, because of the melanin sunblock that exists naturally in their skin, produce only about 800 IU in the 20 minutes. They'd have to spend all day in the sun to produce as much vitamin D that the whites can produce in just 20 minutes. Thus, Black America has to take vitamin D supplements.
Wow, that's 20 times the heart disease rate. What about the other diseases?
Well, Black are more than 3 times as likely to die from cancer than whites. They have 5 times the kidney disease, and they have diseases that are unknown to the whites, such as sickle cell anemia. They also die 7 years before the whites. And the common denominator is that Black Americans avoid the sun like the plague. Whereas in Africa, the blacks with the same genes are in the sun almost all day long, and they virtually have no cancer. Medical researchers are making the cure that claims, such as Ken Chu, in October 16, 2004, University of California, Los Angeles School of Medicine, and he reported vitamin D may play a role in the prevention of diabetes as well as cancer. Many studies have linked vitamin D deficiency to increased risk of type 2 diabetes, which used to be called adult onset diabetes. Vitamin D deficiency is a double jeopardy for type 2 diabetes, concludes Chu. He says he now worries that for people on the cusp of developing the disease, vitamin deficiency may tip the balance.
The claim for cancer cures and diabetes cures are dramatic. And do you have any more reports?
There are hundreds. For example, this one from the February 2nd, 2005 edition of the Arizona Republic, in an article entitled, Sunshine Emerges as a Cancer Risk Remedy. The article reports that new research indicates that, quote, sunlight may help victims survive melanoma. Imagine, the sun does not cause cancer. In a September 2006 Reader's Digest article entitled, The Miracle Vitamin, it quotes that new evidence shows that getting enough vitamin D may be the most important thing that you can do for your health. Further, it quotes that vitamin D sunlight prompts our bodies to make and prevent cancer, a disease, and ward off a whole list of other disorders, such as multiple sclerosis, rheumatoid arthritis, diabetes, and gum disease. It's even shown a promise as a treatment for heart disease and some cancers. Also, there are scientific studies such as, quote, induction of ovarian cancer cell cancer death by vitamin D through the down regulation of telomerase. And that was in the Journal of Biochemical Analysis, 279 volume, issue 51, and December 2004, by Fang Zhang. He's from the Department of Pathology, Oncology, University of Florida College of Medicine. To begin with, a telomere is a coating on the end of every cell, much like the hard coating on the end of a shoelace. As we grow older, the telomerase gradually shrinks and the cell begins to disintegrate and aging occurs. If the telomere did not shrink, aging would never occur. It would be the fountain of youth. The title of this article is therefore claiming that vitamin D degrades cancer telomeres, resulting in the death of the cancer. Quote, vitamin D has been shown to induce cancer death in human cancer cells, but little is known about the underlying mechanism. Our study is the first to link the downregulation of telomerase due to vitamin D-induced cancer cell death. Quote, recent studies from our laboratories have shown that the growth of cancer is suppressed by vitamin D through cell arrest of the telomere. Quote, our data suggests that vitamin D exerts a long-lasting effect on cancer cells because of the loss of the ability to regrow, and it correlates with cancer cell death. Quote, besides decreased growth rate, cancer cells lost their ability to regrow after the removal of vitamin D if they had been treated continuously for longer than 6 days. Quote, our studies show that telomere in cancer cells are disintegrated by vitamin D, therefore removing cancer's immortality. Quote, it's important to point out that the disintegration of the telomerase by vitamin D is detectable in breast cancer cells.
Wow. And you say that there are even more studies than that?
Yes. The one study showed that vitamin D disintegrates the telomere, resulting in the quick death of the cancer cell.